You may have heard the old expression that what we measure matters. What this means is that the things that we measure are the things that we pay attention to, and they drive our behaviours. But what if the thing that you measure doesn't actually tell you what you think that it does? Hello, welcome to this 2-minute tutorial. My name is Phillip Slater and I'm the founder at spareparts.com. In spare parts inventory management, we measure all sorts of different metrics, but there's one in particular that I've found over the years has been reinterpreted in different ways by different companies and therefore gives them, I think, a false sense of satisfaction. And that measure is the stock turn measure. Now, I've done other videos explaining the stock turn measure in detail. So just put simply here, what it does is it tells you whether your inventory is being used, whether it's turning over, hence the word stock turn. Now, what I've found over the years is that companies can sometimes reinterpret the way this measure is calculated, and it can give them a false sense of security. So what do? Well, sometimes they don't include all of their inventory. They're a bit selective about what they include. And so what that does is typically gives them a higher number because they'll exclude the very slow moving items and the insurance spares. Now, the other variation that I've seen quite often is that companies will use all purchases of an item, whether that relates to its requirement as an inventory item or not. So what I mean by that is they may have, let's say, a bearing that they've got sitting on the shelf and they decide they want to hold one of those bearings as part of their inventory. But it comes to a shutdown period and they decide that during a shutdown they're going to replace all six of these bearings that are in use. So they'll order six more bearings and then they'll put those in the plant as part of their maintenance plan and then leave the one on the shelf. Now, at the end of the year, they say to themselves, well, we used six of those bearings throughout the year. We only had one on the shelf, therefore we had a stock turn on that bearing of six. Well, I would say, actually, that's not correct. What I would say is you had one on the shelf, you never actually used it, you had a stock turn of zero. So you can see the importance of making sure you're measuring things and comparing apples for apples in terms of being able to compare your performance to others. My name's Phillip Slater. Thanks for watching this 2-minute tutorial.